Furthering our discussion from the last video where I gave you an overview of how I as a beginner used to target my audience and discussed a few benefits of the same. If you want to check out that video, then click on the I button and you will be taken to the same. In this video, I'll discuss the first kind of audience, which is top of the funnel audience. What should be the kind of content you can show to them and what should be the campaign objective with respect to that piece of content, and while doing so, dive into the detailed targeting options. I'll also reiterate what the top of the funnel audience is. The top of the funnel audience are the people who know about your brand but never purchased from you or might have never heard of your brand. As I already mentioned in the last video, I'll not be talking about the lookalikes over here, although I do consider lookalikes as top of the funnel for the sake of this particular course, but we'll talk about it once I have covered middle of the funnel and bottom of the funnel, and you'll know why later on. Now, coming back to the topic, we have divided the top of the funnel audiences broadly into two categories. The first category is who have never heard about your brand, or maybe your product is so unique that they might have never even heard of your product altogether, like clothes for creators and influencers, or a tool to figure out trending and exploding topics, and many more. The second category is who are aware of your brand but have never purchased from you or might not be thinking of purchasing it from your competition. Let's pick up the first category of audiences and discuss the rules around targeting, campaign objective, and content. But before going further, I should mention that the rules for B2B companies around targeting, campaign objective, and content would remain the same in both the categories. So whatever rules I mentioned for B2B in the first category can also be replicated for the same in the second category as well. Only for B2C they will change. Since the first category audience hasn't heard about your brand, so it wouldn't be a great idea to simply start showing them ads with a FOMO or strike through prices. On average, you need 7 to 8 touch points before making a sale. So the great idea is to reduce the cost of the first touch point and build the trust through the same. Now, I'm hoping you have watched the campaign objective video in this course. If you haven't, then click on the I button and you'll be taken to that video and watch that video first. So coming back to the touch points, since you already know that you need these many touch points, so why not reduce the cost of that? You can reduce the cost of the first touch point by reducing the cost per link click. Therefore, you need to select the traffic objective to get the most affordable traffic to your website. Selecting the traffic objective gives you the lowest cost per link click out of all the campaign objectives that we have. This is applicable for both B2B as well as B2C. The next thing that you have to do is choose detailed targeting. Now, what will you target over here? Let's talk about B2C first. Let's say you are an e-commerce company. You should not go for the obvious audience in this particular category, which is basically engaged shoppers or interests that directly belong to your category, just like if you're a jewelry company or pant and shirt, if you're a clothing brand. Instead, you must be focusing on the peripheral audiences who might be interested in your brand, like office going folks who definitely want formals and accessories, and then go ahead and select various departments like human resources, software engineering, digital marketing, etc. And that will be your audiences in interest category. But you must be thinking, why didn't he choose engaged shoppers or any of the relevant audiences here? I'll explain the same when I talk about the category 2 audiences for B2C. So hold on for that part. But for B2B, you don't need to select the peripheral audience, just select the direct audience. Like if your target audience is CXOs of the companies, then go ahead, focus on the decision makers directly. Moving on. Post that, you have to decide what kind of content you want the traffic to visit. This is where you have to provide free value and build authority to introduce reciprocity principle from psychology, which is my favorite. Let me walk you through what it is. You feel you owe someone when someone does something for you, and you have an irresistible urge to return the favor. The same happens with brand as well, when the brand selflessly goes out of the way and provides free value to its audience. There is a reason why salespeople are distributing free samples of candies, masalas, and snacks to you in a mall. And you really thought that they wanted the feedback? No. Uber, when started out in India, was giving 2 free rides to everyone so that people feel obliged and return the favor later by booking rides from them. That's what you have to do as well over here. If you are a freelancer or an agency owner or any of the other B2B owners, then take people to a step-by-step guide to building something that you sell, or case studies, or an email newsletter. If you are a B2C person from fashion and apparel, then take them to your blog where you have covered DIYs on fashion, like a guide to business attire or the ultimate guide to men's jewelry. The best hack is to collab with one of the influencers and get a video made for your channel and then redirect the traffic to that particular video. You can also do unboxing videos, customer interviews, and a lot more. Now let's focus on the category 2 audience who might have heard of you but have never purchased from you. Although both B2C and B2B have this kind of audience, but the rule of targeting and campaign objective and content for B2B remains the same as we discussed in the first category audience. So first thing, what should be the campaign objective of this particular category. Since they have already heard of you, so you can have campaigns with the conversion as campaign objective. Not for B2B, it will still be clicks. Next is targeting. Over here, you can be direct. If you are an e-commerce, then go ahead with engaged shoppers, sales, etc. If you are an adventure travel, then frequent travelers and all would do the thing for you. Hope I painted the picture for you. The reason why I earlier asked you to focus on the peripheral audience in case of the B2C for the first category of the audience is that in case of B2C, generally the ticket size is small, and I have personally seen a lot of people getting converted very easily even when it was for the first time they were interacting with the brand. Well, it can also happen because Facebook marked them wrongly in top of the funnel audience, but the point is that this audience in case of B2C has higher conversion rate. And there is no point warming up an audience and wasting money when they will buy from you on the first interaction itself. With that, it's time to discuss the content. Create FOMO by using these kind of creatives and finally take them to the product or listing page. That's it. Also, now you know why I was saying that B2B needs to have the content rules which I mentioned in the first category. I have never seen anyone converting a CEO by offering 50% off on a deal. And if you are doing so, then please stop. An important note over here, you need to exclude the middle of the funnel and bottom of the funnel audience from these campaigns. Otherwise, the point of this exercise is useless, and as your top of the funnel will not remain the top of the funnel and would be a hybrid of all the funnels. Hope that makes sense to you. Don't worry if it didn't. It will make sense when I cover the middle of the funnel and bottom of the funnel in my next to next videos. In case you want to know more about how I structure my ad set with these audiences and then figure out which is a winner and which is a dud, then you can go ahead and purchase my book. The link to the same is in the description below. Also, this video is a part of the Facebook ads course, and in order to access the full course, you can click over here. Until next time, bye bye.